Charger Lab has previously tested the charging performance of the iPhone 16 Pro, iPhone 16 Pro Max, and iPhone 16. Today we will test the last model in the 16 series, the iPhone 16 Plus. In terms of configuration, the Plus model is equivalent to an enlarged version of the 16 with a 6.7-inch screen, an A18 processor, and a battery capacity of 4,674 mAh, which is close to the max, larger than the 3,561 mAh of the 16 and the 3,582 mAh of the Pro. However, the USB-C port only supports USB 2.0. The charging cable included in the package is the same as other models. It is white and adopts a woven design. The connector is engraved with A2795 China. ChargerLab Powers EKM003C shows it doesn't have an eMarker chip. It is just a normal 3-amp cable. Compared to the iPhone 15 Plus, the camera arrangement has changed and a camera controls button has been added on the side. In addition, the button positions have changed slightly. The screen size and frame remain the same. The charging power of Plus is similar to that of Max. Under normal circumstances, the power is between 27 and 29 watts. When the screen is on and under load, the instantaneous power can reach a maximum of 36 watts. The USB-C port supports up to USB 2.0 and can be connected to external devices such as USB flash drives for data transmission, but the speed will not be very fast. After all, it is only 480 megabits per second. The maximum power of reverse charging is still 5 watts. Recently, we got a new 25 watts MagSafe charger. When using it to charge the iPhone 16 Plus, the input power can reach about 30 watts, which is much higher than the previous 15 watts. Next, let's do the charging compatibility test. We used some Apple chargers with the original cable to test the real-time power. To test the maximum charging power of the iPhone 16 Plus, the phone will record video throughout the test. Excluding the maximum power limit of the charger, almost all tested chargers can reach a power close to or higher than 30 watts. There are no compatibility issues. Next, we'll use the Apple 70 watts charger to fully charge the iPhone 16 Plus and put them into a 25 degrees Celsius thermotank throughout the test. The voltage is around 15 volts at first, and the charging curve can be divided into 5 parts. In the first part, the peak power stayed at 28 watts for the first 17 minutes. Then the power gradually drops to 21 watts, 15 watts, and 8 watts in turn. Meanwhile, the voltage dropped to 5 volts at 52 minutes. The final part begins at 1 hour and 11 minutes. The power slowly drops to almost zero. It takes 2 hours and 11 minutes to be fully charged. We also turn it into another curve. The Apple 70 watts charger can charge the iPhone 16 Plus to 50% in 27 minutes. And it can reach 80% in 59 minutes, 100% in 2 hours and 11 minutes. The last 20% takes longer. We also recorded the highest temperature on the front and back after charging for 10 minutes, 20 minutes, and 30 minutes. After 10 minutes of charging, the maximum temperature on the front is 36.2 degrees Celsius. The back is 37.2 degrees Celsius. At this time, the charging power is the highest, about 28 watts. After 20 minutes, the maximum temperature on the front is 36.8 degrees Celsius. The back is 37.5 degrees Celsius. After 30 minutes, the maximum temperature on the front is 36.2 degrees Celsius. The back is 37.2 degrees Celsius. From this bar graph, the overall temperature of the phone is between 36.2 and 37.5 degrees Celsius during the 30-minute charging process. The highest temperature is about 37.5 degrees Celsius on the back at 20 minutes. During the charging process, the temperature of the phone rises by less than 1 degree Celsius in 10 to 20 minutes. At 30 minutes, the temperature of the phone is the same as at 10 minutes. The heat dissipation performance has improved. Well, that would be all the tests for the iPhone 16 Plus. Overall, the iPhone 16 Plus performs similarly to the Max model in terms of charging. Under normal circumstances, the charging power is around 28 watts, and the instantaneous power under load can reach a maximum of 36 watts. With the new 25W MagSafe charger, the wireless charging power is significantly improved compared to the old model. However, limited by the 60Hz refresh rate of the screen, it may be a shortcoming for some users who pursue a high refresh experience. Okay, that's all for today's video. Please drop a like, leave your comments, and subscribe to us. See you next time. Bye.